Welcome. We are exploring steps for the project Vedic Mathematics References. Today, our focus is to be the transition from volume 8 to volume 9. This confronts us with the values pair 8 and 9. Value 8 leads us to Asht Prakriti. Of TC value 29, and value 9 takes us to Nav Brahm. Of TC value 45, and the gap is value 16, which is equal to 2 raised to power 4, and it is parallel to the value of the dimensional frame of quadruple spatial dimensions. Same is also parallel to the number of the sutras, as well as is parallel to the number of letters of Sutra 8 as well as Sutra 9. Values pair 8 and 9 has a peculiar coordination because of the specific organization. 8 is equal to 2 raised to power 3 and 9 is equal to 3 raised to power 2. See, 2 raised to power 3 is in comparison to 3 raised to power 2 amounts to a reflection pairing, a vertical reflection pairing, as here the pair of digits 2 and 3 and 3 and 2 swap their places from base and index. So here we have to take note that the Vedic systems, the Vedic mathematics, appears to be availing only the arithmetic operations, our classical arithmetic operations of addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication. However, here we will be confronted with that it is in fact availing a reflection pair, pairing a reflection as an operation, and this reflection as operation is not only being availed in a horizontal format as we is available 0, 1 and 10. It is here that values 8 and 9 means in between this reflection zone, it is a vertical reflection pairing. So reflection pairing is one operation which is distinct and is specifically available in the Vedic systems. Firstly, it is available as a reflection, like a mirror image reflection, as is 0, 1 and 10. Then it is available in a vertical reflection, and it is like 2 raised to power 3 and 3 raised to power 2. Further, it is available in the script forms of letter SHA, which takes to value 2 and which takes to value 4. It is also available in the form of the script of 3 and 6. It is further available in the form of this TA, a letter, and the fourth component of the sole syllable OM. Still further, it is also available to us in the form of 8 and infinity. This way we see that reflection pairing is an operation which is of prominent application in the Vedic systems, when we will be transcending value 7, when we will be transcending the linear progression, and we will be entering a special order, creative space mathematics, as the Vedic mathematics says. Still further, we see that when we are in a square and we have its quadruple parts, four quarter squares, then this here we are having reflection pair of very wide range of application. It is here where we will have a flow, vertical as well as the horizontal, simultaneously happening at the center of the quadruple quarter subsquares of the square. This phenomenon, as we have seen, is also available in the pair of orientations, particularly in the setup of the interval hypercube 1, one space body, where plus 1 is the domain and minus 1 is the dimension. So this shift from the plus 1 as domain to minus 1 as dimension, we can see that there happens to be an absolute distinct formats altogether. While we are along the positive orientations, say while we are proceeding from west to east, while we are proceeding towards the sun, we are along the, say, plus one orientation, a domain fold. But while we will be coming from sun down to earth, the very format will change. There will be a shift from domain to a dimension. It is this shift from domain to a dimension which is the processing format of the creator's space, where the spatial order setup is available. Now let us see that value 8 as 2 raised to power 3 will take us to a setup of a three-dimensional setup. However, at value 9 as 3 square, we are restricting ourselves only to a plane format. How this shift of the format and sequential increase of a value and the decrease of the dimensional format, it is this happening which is to be taken care of while we will be transiting from volume 8 to volume 9. This in fact is going to be shift from Asht Prakriti to now Brahm. And Asht Prakriti, we know, is of value 29. Now it is this value 29 which deserves to be imbibed. Now it is here when we reach at the text of Sutra 8, it leads us to TC value 67, and Sutra 9, Chalna Kalna Bhyam, leads us to value 55. Now 8 as formulation Asht is taking us to TC value 11, and we know that the sum of 1 to 10 is 55. See, chapter 11 of Srimad Bhagavad Gita is of 55 shlokas range. It is designated as Vishwaroop Darshan Yoga, and formulation Vishwaroop Darshan Yoga is of TC value 67, and formulation Vishwaroop Darshan is of value 55. This organization, this coordination deserves to be comprehended well. Sadhakas are fulfilled with intensity of urge to be parallel with the Vedic systems, Vedic mathematics, shall sit comfortably and permit the transcending mind to have a simultaneous comprehensive view of the pair of values 8 and 9, and also to have a reach at the TC values of formulations Asht Prakriti and Nav Brahm. Here, the organization of Srimad Bhagavad Gita is to provide us proper leads and enlightenment, and in particular, the chapter 11 with value 11 parallel to TCV of Asht, a formulation for 8, 8 as Asht with TC value 11, leads us to Vishvarup Darshan Yoga of TC value 67, and it is of 55 shlokas range. Now, these are the wide range of features of values pair 8 and 9, which deserve to be comprehended well, to have a transition from Sutra 8 to Sutra 9, or to have a transition from the mathematics of 8 space to 9 space, we have to be very slow, as it in fact is going to be a big shift from complete and incomplete existence phenomenon to a static state transition into a dynamic state. How the 9 points range is having 8 gaps. 9 points are leading to 8 gaps. How the value 9 is leading us to 19 geometries range, while value 8 is leading us to 17 geometries range. We know value 17 is the value of the northern hemisphere, and value 19 is of the southern hemisphere. Now see, when we are such a wide distinctive formats of reach, then this reach is separated by a coordination, and it is this coordination which is of value 18 parallel to the fourfold manifestation layer of hypercube of 5. So it is hypercube of 5 which is to play the role of coordination of the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. We are acquainted with the core of the earth being a seat of creators of space. Core of earth is a four space seat. Hypercube 4, the four space body, is providing the format for the core of the earth. Now four space itself is having five space in the role of an origin. There is a transcendental origin. So there happens a transcendental phenomenon. The Asht Prakriti as of TC value 29 is equal to the TC value of Brahma, the overlord of real four space, a format of the core of the earth, which is having a transcendental origin. Five space as the origin. It is this five space as the origin which is putting a seal at the core of the earth. And it is because of this transcendental seal at the core of the earth that earth remains an integrated domain. Earth is a synthetic setup of its northern hemisphere and a southern hemisphere. The core of the earth is a seat of the creator's space. It is the fourth space which is playing the role of an origin of a three space. So earth as a three space body and as a synthetic setup of northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere is having an origin of the values of the creator. The creator fourth space is stabilized at the transcendental base. So five space as the transcendental base of the creative origin of our earth is playing the role, because of which we will see that when there happens to be a dynamic state for the earth, so transition from the static state of the earth as a three space body with four space as origin of five space as a base, when is in a dynamic state, it because of the creative origin, because of the spatial order of the creative origin, that the earth is stabilized in dynamic state by having a dual dynamic motions. Firstly, the earth is having a motion, a revolution around its own axis, and then simultaneously as an integrated setup of northern and hemispheres revolving around its own axis is having a motion around the sun. This is the setup with terms of which we will be in a position to have a transition from the format of the mathematics of Ganita Sutra 8 to the format of the mathematics of Ganita Sutra 9. In popular translation, the Sutra 9 is a differential calculus rule of reaching at the derivatives, differentiation. But we are not appreciating that this is not the complete interpretation of the formulation Chalana Kalanabhyam of Ganita Sutra 9. Here in Chalana, there is a Kalana as well. That means there is an integration as well. It is not only that they in a dynamic state, a Chalana form, there happens a derivations of 1 degree reduction at the index, a raised to power n is to n, b raised to power n minus 1. But we know that the boundary is of 2n form. Then it is only the half of the boundary which comes into play while we are taking account of derivatives. The integration would mean that because of the dynamic state, the transcendental flow within ka Brahma, within the reservoir, is of Atharva. It goes in the form of reach for a solid as a liquid, but in a stabilized form. Atharva, it is having a stabilized position. How in a dynamic state the stability stands achieved? How in a dynamic state the northern and southern orbits stand synthesized without having any disturbance for the stabilized state of existence in the northern hemisphere and the southern hemispheres both simultaneously and independently? It is this complementary and supplementary feature of the Sutra 7 to Sutra 9, we are sankalan vyakalanabhyam. Whatever is accumulated, that is to be utilized. Sankalan vyakalanabhyam. Now, this accumulation and its utilization, when reaches in a Purna and Apurna Bhyam, as a complete zone and as an incomplete zone, both synthesized as a complete zone, then ahead in a dynamic state and the flow, because of the dynamic state, having an accumulation, chalna reaching a kalna, and there is going to be again a stability. These three sutras, 7, 8 and 9, make a complete dynamic model of our solar universe along the Vedic format. Here we can have a pause and see that the values 1, 2 and 3, as we see, are unique in the sense that none of these is a composite number. However, the values 8, 9 and 10 is again unique, as all of them are composite. In between is 4, 5, 6 and 7, and its value is 22, which is equal to hypercube 6. All these features are coming into play when we will be progressing for the unfolding, in inner unfolding setup of the mathematical domain of Ganita Sutras, as Sutra 1 to Sutra 16. So as we shall be progressing, as we shall be transcending sequentially from Sutra 1 to Sutra 2 and so on, from Sutra 7 to Sutra 8, and now from Sutra 8 to Sutra 9, then we also have to be conscious and we have to be very well parallel to all these transition features coming into play. And the halt here is to be that there is going to be a bend here. It is this inherent bend in the organization format of Ganita Sutras at Sutra 8 to Sutra 9 because of the vertical reflection pairing. It is an internal inherent feature of the artifices 8 and 9, and hence of 8 space and 9 space body, and hence of Sutra 8 and Sutra 9. So the gaps between Sutras 1 to 8 as such are filled by Upsutras 1 to 7. And here there is an inherent bridging coordination. No further external bridging is required. And then further from here, Upsutras 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13 come into play. And again we know Sutras 16 and 15 are the sutras of 16 letters each. And here as well, there is an inherent lock. It is that within a four space, we are having a dimensional frame of value 16. But at the center, there is a transcendental origin. And this origin is having a solid dimensional order, which is of value 15. So this lock 16 and 15 is inherently available because of the transcendental origin seat of the creators of space. And this inherent lock, this inherent coordination is available because of the inherent properties of 8 space and 9 space, or of values 8 and 9, because of the vertical processing. These features deserve to be comprehended well before having a transition from Sutra 8 to Sutra 9. Now let us see. The Sutra 8 in its TCV values format, in its seven forms of TCV TTCV, FFTC, FTC, HTCV, TRCV, and STRCV. Now, for all the 16 letters, all these 7 folds, so 7 into 16 is equal to 112, which is equal to 81 plus 31, and which is equal to square and cube. So here in both, we have to be having a foundational, we know when will be TRCV here. In both cases is of same value. We have to have a comparison of all these 7 column volumes, 7 column values for all the 16 letters of Sutra 9 with Sutra 8. It is this comparison of the 7-fold TCV values unfolding setup of the 16 letters of Gnita Sutra 8 and of 16 letters of Sutra 9. With this, we will be in a position to have a appropriate insight and enlightenment of the transition happening between the mathematical domains of Gnita Sutra 8 and Guru Gnita Sutras 9. It is in the light of this insight and it is in the light of this enlightenment that we have to proceed for having specific, distinct vision for volume 9 vis-a-vis the specific mathematical domain of Sutra 8. Thank you very much.